hours in each day, in the weekday and the weekends. When we will be consulting coverage across the, you know, the AMEs, compared with proposal and compared with now.
Sure, thanks for that question. In terms of, I'll do now first, that might be the easiest way to start off. So at St Mary's Hospital, we have 12, you can correct me if I get anything wrong, we have 12 ED consultants, and at that hospital, we see about 36,500 patients, or about 100 patients a day in the AED department. At Charing Cross, we have 5.6 ED consultants, and at Hammersmith, the department at present time is not staffed by ED consultants. So at the present time, the department is staffed by 3.5 acute physician consultants.
Can you clarify what their specialty is?
Yeah, so in St Mary's, they're ED physicians, so they're trained through the Royal College of Emergency Physicians at both St Mary's Hospital and at Charing Cross, whereas at Hammersmith, they're physician trained, so they're not ED specialists.
But are they cardiologists?
So they will be a range of specialties. They might be general physicians, for example. So trained through the College of General Physicians. I think it's worth pointing out that in terms of Hammersmith, and in thinking about the changes at the Hammersmith AME, there are some clinical concerns that we have in that department at the moment. When we look at the current staffing in the middle grade rotas, so that's the doctors that sit underneath the acute physicians, for the past couple of years we've had between 40 and 60% vacancy rate in covering with permanent staff that middle grade rota. So in thinking about the changes to the Hammersmith A&E, is there have been changes as part of shaping a healthier future? Even if we put shaping a healthier future to one side, there have been clinical concerns about how long we can continue to maintain safe coverage in the Hammersmith A&E department. So going forward, in terms of the Hammersmith staffing, the urgent care centre has gone from a 12-hour a day to a 24-hour a day urgent care centre, and that is staffed by GPs going forward with nurses and nurse practitioners. In terms of the additional medical staff going into each of the departments, just bear with me. For St Mary's, we have a number of additional, five additional A&E consultants that are being approved through a business case at the moment, which will extend the cover of A&E consultants to 12 hours at the weekends and to midnight Monday and Friday. At the moment they're till 8 p.m. is it? On Monday and Friday, and at the weekends at the moment they're till 8. In terms of Charing Cross, we have three additional core medical trainees going into the Charing Cross ED. No additional emergency physicians going into the Charing Cross ED.
How many people, please?
So in terms of numbers going through each of the emergency departments, at St Mary's we have about 100 patients a day going through the A&E department, and we have about 160 a day going through the urgent care centre at St Mary's. At Charing Cross we have about 80 patients presenting a day, and about 120 going through the urgent care centre. And at Hammersmith, we've had 60 patients a day going to the ED. The urgent care centre, whilst it was a 12-hour a day, it was 80 patients a day. I know that's a lot of stats, sorry.
And now, sorry, that's 24-7.
Now it's 24-7, so we would expect that to increase.
So we haven't mentioned it yet.
Because of the number?
And it's too early to be, I'm sure. We've been seeing about